Well, we do want to get to a very familiar face for our Local 4 viewers, a person that also knew Aretha Franklin very well. Former anchor here at WDIV, Carmen Harlan, joining us by phone now. Very sad to hear the news, Carmen, I would imagine, but thank you for joining us.
Oh, Evrod, Rhonda, my thoughts and prayers are with Aretha's family right now. I'm, you know, even when you know this day is coming, it's still something that you're not really prepared for. So when I learned of the news, watching you guys this morning, I mean, I had to sit down. And as I said, we knew she hadn't been well, but hearing it is still shocking and still stunning. I can't imagine. Mm-hmm. I can't imagine Detroit without Aretha.
Yeah.
Well, Carmen, being a native Detroiter, you have watched Aretha make beautiful songs and music and seen her performed over the decades. Talk about your perspective of Aretha Franklin.
You know, I don't know if we truly, especially when I was younger, if I knew the vast talent that she represented. And certainly as I got older and got a chance to cover her as a young reporter, and then got a chance to be the recipient of many invitations to her her parties, and you know, I got to know her not just as as the icon and the legend that she was and is and will always be, but I got to know her as a person too. And she had a very generous side. I can remember there was the loss of a family. A father was trying to keep his house warm in the winter, and the house caught fire, and all of the children in the family perished. And quietly, and in her own way, in Aretha's style, Aretha paid for the funeral.
Wow.
For those children. And she was known for doing things like that, and always giving back. And she cared about her art. I mean, she worked up probably, I'm sure, up until the day that she couldn't. And retirement was never part of her vocabulary.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And but, you know, her music will transcend time. You know, her voice, her talent was an arrow from God.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he wanted everybody in the world to know this voice out of Detroit, Aretha Franklin. And eventually we stopped calling her Aretha Franklin. We just called her Aretha. And everybody knew who you were talking about. And I can look back over my life and, you know, as growing up in the 60s and the 70s, and there's a song that just captures the moment, whether it was the civil rights moment, when we walked down Woodward Avenue toward Cobo Hall to hear a young minister, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, deliver his I Have a Dream speech. And, you know, I can hear the music of Aretha behind that. In the 70s, you know, driving on the freeway, and I probably had just gotten my license. You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
So her music was a backdrop, actually.
Absolutely.
for most of our lives. Not just, and you think about it, just how much of a gift she was, not just to us. We had Motown, too, and Aretha Franklin,
yeah,
both coming out of the city of Detroit. I mean, we were riding pretty high at that time, culturally. And with everything going on, the music kept us going, and the music gave us the hope and the spiritual nourishment that we needed. And if you wanted to sing in the shower quietly, who do you think you wanted to sound like? Come on.
Absolutely.
You know,
very
you wanted
true.
To sound like Aretha.
Yeah.
You know?
Very true.
But who could? There is only one. There will only be one.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, I am so glad that I had a chance to get to know her.
Mm-hmm.
I really am.
And talk about, too, I mean, her talent was vast, but her music was significant for that time and
she
what
could
the
do
message
anything.
Was.
She could do anything. Remember when Pavarotti couldn't sing?
That's my most memorable moment.
He couldn't perform whatever the aria he was supposed to perform. And who did they ask to step in and do that?
Mm-hmm.
They asked Aretha. And if you hear it, if you ever get a chance to hear it, I mean, she certainly was not a classical singer, but she held her own on that. You had to respect her.
Yeah.
If they asked her to perform in a film, you know, I mean, Hollywood called, right? She was in the Blues Brothers, married to the, was he the drummer in their band? They were trying to Incredible. Put back together. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I mean, she played that part. She could do anything.
Yeah.
Much, and, you know, for the people who were close enough to her to feel like family, I mean, you know they're going to miss her.
Yeah. And yet so humble at the same time. Mm-hmm. I think that's what's so remarkable about her.
I think that's the spirit of Detroit, Rhonda.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And, you know, people ask you, well, what is it, you know, what does it mean to be a Detroiter? Well, it means a lot.
Yeah.
You know, we've had some very tough times. We've gotten through those. We're in a rebuilding stage. You can see, you know, that there's an energy coming from not just inside of the city, but around the city. And it's all connected. And Aretha represented all of that.
Yeah.
You know, 76 is kind of young. So, you know, would we have wanted to have her a lot longer? You bet we would. But we have to say goodbye, and that's going to be real tough.
And we're thankful for the time that we have. We have had
The music will last forever.
Absolutely.
Yes, it will.
Well, Carmen, thank you so much for your perspective and for sharing your relationship with her.
It's a very special perspective.
And again, my thoughts and prayers to Aretha's family.
Yeah.
And we'll miss her.
I know you lost a friend, so our condolences are with you as well, Carmen.